Traveling in different kinds of vehicles, visiting new places, witnessing new spectacles. Well, today we will hear the story of the grandest vehicle ever built in the history of time. Who were the automobile engineers? Well, let us listen to a new episode of Lord Shiva. Now, as we know, in the last episode, we had heard about how Kartikeya grew up to be a war general of the Devatas, and he defeated and killed Tarakasur, the evil demon. Now, Tarakasur had three sons. Their names were Kamalaksha, Vidyunmali, and Tarakaksha. They were boiling with anger. In fact, though they were devotees of Lord Shiva, they were very hurt and saddened by the death of their father, and so they decided to go and appease Lord Brahma and get a boon of immortality. And so they began their severe austerities, which went on for hundreds of thousands of years. In the heat of the summer, they would surround themselves with the scorching fire and perform austerities. In the winter, they would bathe in the icy cold waters and worship the Lord. In the autumn, they would give up food and offer whatever food they had to charity. And so it went on until Lord Brahmaji was appeased, and he appeared before them and asked them what they wished. Now, as we know, all the asuras always ask for the boon of immortality. But Lord Brahmaji said that only Hari and Hara, Vishnu and Shiva, would be immortal. Every other being had to die one day. And so the three brothers thought of a plan. And they asked Lord Brahmaji that he bless them with an impregnable fortress or three cities which could never be destroyed except by a single arrow shot by Lord Shiva. And at an opportune moment, when these three cities that they had been blessed with would come in a straight line. This would happen only once in 1,000 years, when the sun would come in Abhijit Nakshatra and the moon would come in Pushya Nakshatra. Now, the three brothers, being devotees of Lord Shiva, were sure that the Lord would never harm his devotee. So they thought they were as good as immortal, and Lord Brahmaji blessed them with this. So one of the asuras, who was an architect, the son of Diti, Mayadano, was given the task of constructing these huge beautiful cities. The lowest city had walls made of iron and was on the earth. The second city had walls made of silver and was in the sky. And the third city had walls made of gold and was in the heavens above. These cities were mobile. And so, sitting in these three cities, the three brothers would take a tour of all the 14 worlds. And these cities were filled with such luxuries, magnificent ponds, fountains, lakes, mango groves, orchards, gold, silver, gems, and unimaginable wealth. And so, all the asuras started flocking and began living in these cities. Initially, there was peace and harmony because these brothers were devotees of Lord Shiva. So, in addition to all the luxuries, there were temples, pujas would be conducted, yagnas were held, and people lived in peace. However, the inherent tendencies of the asuras began to surface, and so they began thinking that why waste time on worship? It was enough to eat, drink and be merry. And so, when the faith in the Lord starts diminishing, one's fall is assured. Because till one has faith, nobody can harm the devotee. And so it was that the asuras began tormenting the good, they started attacking, looting the heavens, the sages, the Siddha Purushas, and all the innocent devotees of the Lord. Now, even the Devatas kept losing battle after battle with the Asuras, because within these three fortresses was a pool of life-giving water. So even when Nandi, the strong bull, went and attacked and killed one of the brothers, Vidyunmali, he was revived in no time because of this life-saving water. And so all the Devatas, now at a loss, decided to approach Lord Brahmaji. Lord Brahmaji, having given the boon himself, couldn't do anything and so directed them to Lord Shankara, the auspicious one. Lord's heart melted on hearing their plight, and he assured them that he would help them and now to go ahead and begin preparing the great chariot for the war. This chariot was like no other. The five elements of the earth formed the body of the chariot. The inside was the Mandara mountain. The sharp edges were the Kesara mountain. Brahmaji was the charioteer with Omkar as his whip. The four horses were the four Vedas. And the reins were none other than the various Devatas. The right wheel was the sun himself with the 12 spokes of the 12 Adityas. The left wheel was the moon with the 16 colors or the 16 faces. The six seasons were the rims of the wheels, and the constellations were the decorations. Goddess Saraswati also accompanied Brahmaji as the bell in the chariot. The heavens formed the flag atop the chariot, while Lord Vishnu was the divine arrow. The tip of the arrow was Agni, while Vayu formed the feathers on the back of the arrow. Now, what was the bow? The bow was Mount Meru, the center of the universe. The string of the bow was Shesha, the serpent of time. Such was the divine chariot, never seen before. All the Devatas came to witness this spectacle. And Lord Shiva was about to get in when he realized that the Devatas had become proud of their accomplishment, and so he waited. Lord Shiva knew that just by a smile and by opening his third eye, he could destroy the three cities and reduce them to ashes. Now, the Devatas realized that they were being foolish, and then prostrating to the Lord, asked him to lead them. As we know, Lord Ganesha has to be invoked before we embark on any task, and so even Lord Shiva performed the worship of Lord Ganesha and then took up his bow, waiting for that opportune moment. The three cities had begun coming in a straight line. At that last instant, before Lord Shiva took aim, the three Danavas realized that their time had come, the end was near, and they realized their folly. So just as the Lord let out the arrow, they focused on the feet of Lord Shiva. They asked him, "When will you give us this chance to have your darshan again in this rarest of rare forms? We would wish to die again and again if it is by gaining your darshan. Please bless us that we will remain forever submerged at your feet." And soon they just fell down. The three cities collapsed, all the Asuras died, and there were only ashes remaining. However, because Mayadana was a devotee of Lord Shiva, and Lord will never forsake his devotees, could escape in time because Nandi the bull had gone and warned him. And Lord Shiva, now taking the ashes of the three cities, applied it on his forehead. This is known as the Tripundra, the holy mark seen on the foreheads of all the Shiva devotees. This reminds us of the three cities that we have with us: our body, mind, and intellect. which always roams around seeking enjoyments in this world of fascinating objects, and we lose focus of the Lord. This mark reminds us that we always ought to remember the Lord and never forsake the path of Dharma. Destroying the three cities of Tripura, Lord Shiva got the name of Tripurantaka. May we also pray to the Lord Tripurantaka to help us remain on the path of Dharma, to never forget him ever. If you like today's story, do share it with your friends, ask them to subscribe to this channel and join us week after week. I will be back with another story on Lord Shiva the next Thursday. Until we meet again, Hari Om.